So in the new Keynote version 7.1, there's a handy new feature that's especially useful if you've got very complex slides with lots of stuff on them. So for instance, here I've got a slide that's got a bunch of different things on it, and you know, if you've used Keynote a lot, it can get even more complex than that. You can have things behind other things and all. So this new feature, if you can activate it by going to View and then Show Object List, puts another sidebar here on the left that gives you a list of all the items on the slide. So you can select them by simply selecting the item in the list, and you can see it changes the selection that's there. You can hold the Command key down and select to select multiple items. You can do things like select an item here and then delete. I'll undo that. You also have a little lock next to it to easily lock and unlock items. That was something that was possible before, but it was a little difficult to use. Now it's very easy to use with this object list. The object list stays there even when you switch slides. So you can see here I've got it and it just stays there. It's a very useful feature. If you're doing lots of Keynote presentations, you're going to love being able to use this. You can also drag and drop to move things on top of other things. So I can move like this behind. And you can control click on things to get all the same options you get when you control click on it in here. So it's a great feature to use. You can use it, of course, with all your existing presentations and use it as you create new ones as well. So a few other advanced items here. One is there are two different ways to select something here. If I click once, you can see it's kind of a light highlight there. But if I double click, then it's a dark highlight there. Now you got to be careful when you double click to click on the icon there, because if I simply double click on the name, then I get to rename the item, which is very useful because this one's going to be automatically named by the file name of this image. This one's going to automatically be named by the text in there, but I can just call it something else to make it a little easier. Now also, when you're in this mode here, while it's got the darker highlight, I can use the arrow keys to move up and down on the list, which is very useful. Also, when you group items together, so let me select these two and I can select arrange group, it puts them together here with a little reveal triangle underneath it. And you can also do that inside of here. So I can select two using command click, control click on them, and group, and we'll put these two together in there. And you're supposed to be able to drag items in and out of here, but I haven't seen how you can do that. It doesn't seem to work. Perhaps the way I have these images arranged or put on here is preventing that. And you can also filter these items. So say you have a slide with a ton of different items on it. There's a filter button here at the bottom, and I could say only show me text or only show me shapes. Now you can see that one shape, or just show me the images. So the filtering options, let's see if I do images here. Now it's just filtered to only images, and I can turn it on and off very easily. So I can do the same thing, go to this slide, and the image filter is still there, and I can turn it on and off to easily jump and see maybe just the images or just the text on a given slide. And here is perhaps the coolest thing about the object list, is it doesn't just have to be for one slide. I can select this slide, and I'm going to command click to select a second slide. You can select as many as you want, and you can see it says slide 2, slide 3, and the objects for each one are represented. So I could actually select all the slides here, and you can see 1, 2, 3, 4. And you can even drag items between slides. So I can select this image here and drag it up to put it in this slide, and you can see it moved slides. So that's a really easy way to actually move items from slide to slide. You can imagine in a slideshow having text and images and being able to swap the text and images between slides very easily, whereas before you just had to do lots of copying and pasting.